Says I love palm trees so much I want to dry hump them.
What's up, YouTube? I'm Rio, and I'm on a mission to go from a broke-ass, middle-aged, no-named artist to owning a seven-figure-a-year empire that revolves around my art. I'm hoping to get this done without having to have a boob job or a facelift, because it seems that in this industry, that a bikini body is the only way to get attention on social media, and that ship has sailed. Anyway, I'm gonna bring you along and share with you my progress. The good, the bad, the ugly, and the oh my god, I pooped my pants. All without trying to sell you some overpriced how to make a living as an artist e-course that you don't even need.
Video number two of being back, and we're like on track. I can't even believe it. So anyway, if you're new here, I'm Rio, and I'm on a mission to build a seven-figure-a-year empire using my art. Now, the elephant in the room is that it's really hard to make a living selling art is what you always get told. And I honestly haven't sold a thing yet this year, and it's May. But, you know, I'm working on that. So I'm currently working on a 30 pieces in 30 days because I've realized that I don't paint near enough to make a living as an artist, and that is the problem. With the internet, you should be able to sell everything that you make if you've got your stuff together. So my problem is definitely the consistency in painting, and the last 30 days, it feels like everything's come together. The planets have aligned. Oh, the angels are singing, the whole nine yards. And like, I actually understand my own painting style. So I'm super excited because I'm doing 30 pieces in 30 days. At the end of the month, that means that I get to launch my very first collection and you guys get to watch it evolve. So we'll see how it goes. It's going to be a kitchen collection on the charcuterie boards and the live edge pieces of wood because I'm in love with those. If you want to track the progress of my 30-day challenge, make sure you head over and subscribe to me or follow me or whatever we're calling it on Instagram, because I'm posting dailies over there so that you can kind of see what's going on behind the scenes, and then you can gear up if you gotta have one, because I'm telling you.
Instagram and?
TikTok.
There you go.
And Facebook.
There you go.
Woo! So today we're starting with palm trees. Woo! Love palm trees. I love old palm trees, and I can't wait to have my own palm tree at some point. Says it's an orphan. Oh my god, it's literally a palm tree.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, we have to plant this, Says. We have to go get in a pot right now. Hi, I'm Rio. I'm your new mommy. I should draw a face on your face. Oh my
god, we go name it Wilson.
Wilson! Oh my god, we have to stop what we're doing. Look, it literally has roots. Says, we gotta go plant this right now. Let's go, right now.
Did you lock the back door?
No, I didn't! I'm so excited. The excitement with my vertigo, it might not be such a good idea. Yes, I'm driving with vertigo. I've learned to live with it.
Yeah, I'm one with the vertigo.
I am one with the vertigo. I got a palm tree.
What if it's not a palm tree?
You shut your mouth, Sace. It is a palm tree. It's growing out of the nut. What else would it be? You're not gonna get a hibiscus growing out of a coconut.
We're getting cake here, right?
If by cake you mean a pot and soil, yeah.
getting a planter for a coconut.
See, so coconut can't be lonely. It'll grow better. Statistics show that plants are happier when they have other friends to be there with. Ask Bob Ross. I needed to get him a happy little friend, and look how happy this hibiscus is. Well, not this bloom in particular, but this one is gonna be really happy. And look at this one. Oh my God, I gotta paint that. Do you think you would like this bucket? I think it would fit you very nicely. Oh, so here, let's have a look. This is his face. There's his eyes, and that's his mouth. Look, do you think you would like this bucket? I think this one would work. So we'll start you out in here.
Okay.
two more done. We normally film this outside, all staged and all pretty, but it's raining, so you're stuck with the indoor look. So two more pieces. They're still taped. I gotta put one more layer of resin on these because they have a teeny tiny blemish in each one of them because resin, because that's why, resin. But other than that, I think they turned out great. I'm super excited for the way they look and can't wait to get them online. So, hope you enjoyed the second episode on a Friday like we promised. Until next time, thanks for joining us in the studio. Ciao!